Welcome back friends. In the previous video, I have discussed about what is kernel. In today's video, I will go further and discuss about the types of kernels. So there are basically many types of kernel. I will discuss three important types of kernels. First one is monolithic kernel. Monolithic kernel is some kernel in which the kernel contains all the four processes. I have discussed that there are four processes. First one is process management, second one is file management, third one is memory management, fourth one is IO management. When in a same kernel, all the four code of the management is written, in that kernel is known as a monolithic kernel. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of this type of kernel? First one is, if all the code are written in the same places, then if any one of the process get crashed or any problem come in the one of the process, all the kernel get crashed, all the operating system get crashed. And because all the kernel are present in one place, the size of the kernel get increases, memory requirement to operate this kernel get increases. These are the problem of this kernel. But there is a one very good advantage of this kernel is that communication between each of the module is become very fast, because all the modules present in a one kernel space, due to which the communication is very fast in this type of mode, in this type of kernel. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of monolithic kernels. Example of this type of kernel is a Linux system. Linux system use this type of kernel. Now let us move to the different types of other kernels. Other kernel is microkernel. Microkernel has very less size as compared to the monolithic kernel, because in user space, not only application is present, along with it, file management and IO management is also present. So kernel only contains two different modules. First one is process management, second one is a memory management, due to which the size of this kernel is less. So memory required to run this kernel is very less. And because if any one of this kernel gets crashed, the chances of crashing the whole system decrease. So the reliability of this kernel is also increases. But there is a one big disadvantage with this kernel, that is communication. As different module is present in the different spaces, so to communicate between each of them, there is a increase of switching to communication. Switching increases for communication, so communication is very slow. And this type of kernel is used by the Symbianian OS. So if we analyze the both the kernel, monolithic kernel has a fast communication, but size is increased. Microkernel has a slow communication, but size is decreasing. So can we find any kernel which has the advantages of both? Yes, that is called hybrid kernel. So let us see that. In hybrid kernel, user space contains two things, application along with file management. So kernel only has three things: memory management, IO management, process management, due to which size of this is less than monolithic kernel, and communication between them is more than microkernel, because switching is less, because only file management is present in a user space. So switching become less, communication become fast, and size become decreases, due to which this is a one of the most used kernel. And this type of kernel is used in a Windows system. Windows 10, 7 use this type of kernel, Mac OS use this type of kernel. So in today's video, we have discussed about three different type of kernel. First one is monolithic kernel, in which single piece of kernel contain all the four processes, due to which size increases, memory required to run this kernel is high. But problem is that if one module crash, the entire system gets crashed. Communication between each module become very fast. This type of kernel is used by the Linux and Unix. Second one is micro kernel. Micro kernel size become very less because only memory and process management is present in the kernel. Memory requirement become less. And the problem in one module cannot crash the whole system. That is one of the advantages which does not present in the monolithic kernel. So the reliability of this kernel increases because the crashing problem is less. But the communication requirement is very slow because the switching come. So the performance of this type of kernel is also get decreased. This type of kernel is used by the Symbian OS. Now the next kernel, which has the disadvantage and advantage of both the kernel, is hybrid kernel, in which file management and application is present in user, and kernel contains three things: IO, memory, and process. Due to which is communication becomes faster than micro kernel. Size is slower than monolithic kernel. So it is one of the most used kernel used in Windows 10 Mac OS. In the next video, I will discuss about how the communication happens between them. With the help of switch call. So stay tuned with me for the next video. Till then, goodbye.